Alright guys, so in the last video we were able to create our simple small server using Node Express, as well as we created two routes, and these routes are accessible, as well as we also created our uploader middleware function in our middleware's file, and we imported it in our images routes. So basically I'm gonna copy and paste it. I think I made some mistakes, so this is the line which I'm not gonna use. Okay, so we brought in uploader middleware from there, and we injected them for the single files as well as the double files. So now what I'm gonna do is simply gonna create our single file uploader. So first of all, I'm gonna create an image path, and that we can access. Okay, let's before doing anything, let's see what happens with these. Okay, for now I'm gonna open up my Postman. So in my apps, and I open up the Postman, and this might take a moment to do that, and hope you have already installed to test our APIs. And I'm gonna close these things because we don't need anything from Google Chrome so far. It's taking quite a bit to open up. Okay. Okay, it's taking quite a bit of time. Here we have the Postman. I don't know why it's taking time. Yeah, maybe I haven't used this for a long time, that's why. And once we have opened our Postman to test our APIs, let me quickly increase the font sizes. And these are my other windows which I'm currently house working on. So I'm not gonna save any of them. Don't save it. Close it, don't save it. Close one by one. So basically, now I'm gonna test our API and let's see what happens. And here we are going to our code, and I'm gonna console log, simple console log to the request.files object, and that is a request.file.files. It will be request.file because we are dealing with a single file. And in the same way, I'm gonna put a console log statement list of files. So here we are getting a bunch of files, as well as here we'll be having a single file. And I'm gonna return empty response, return list.json, and in that response I will simply send request of, let's say, message hello. I'm gonna copy this part, paste it over there. So this will be a fake dummy API for now, and let's see if we are gonna face any kind of problem. So we'll test it out over here. Let me quickly increase the font size and everything of this. Okay, so now we are gonna test our API. Let me shrink this one. And by default our server is running on localhost 3000. And endpoint is api/images/single. Upload. Upload. And now once we are done, we are gonna go to our body part and the form data. And let's say I was pulling it from file object. Instead of text, this will be a file, and now we are gonna select one file. So let's see how it works. And I have a very simple image which I have. I'm gonna upload this one, gonna open up and set it. So let's see, I'm getting my message back. That means our API worked. And if I go to terminal, you can see these are the fields that we are getting in our request.file, which we console log over here, request.file. And in the uploads directory, you can see that file has also been created. So that file has been created over here, and now we can use that file over here. But if you go to our APIs, so let's say if we console log that part, we have a destination directory and now we have to play around with this one. And the way we can do that is simply give some kind of link to that file so that we can access that file. And one more thing before doing anything, if I go and open up my browser, so let me open it up from the different, okay. And if I go to the localhost 3000, you can see that file is accessible. So uploads and slash after that the name of the file that I'm gonna copy it from the terminal. So that's a file name, copy, and then I'm gonna paste it over here and press enter. You can see that file is now already available to be visible and we can access it from APIs. We can dynamically put in our applications, use them. So now what I need to do is little bit of giving a linked URL so that you can save them and associate with that. So we are not going to do anything fancy over here. It will be a simple JavaScript function, image path. I'm gonna create a variable called image path, and then we are gonna request a file dot path. So since if we have the path over here, this is the path. So we just need this part of that, right? So we will play some things with our string functions, and we'll create our path with our local host or the base URL which we'll be using. And we'll be replacing with the path replace, and in that I'm gonna replace public with the base URL. Okay, and since the base URL we have already defined in our configuration, or we can also put it inside env, so I'm gonna replace that public with the base URL. And then image path will be set to image path dot split. So I'm gonna split that and src from that path, and then we are gonna simply split first. So this split function will be like, since we have uploaded everything, we'll be replacing this public with our base URL, but still we'll be having whole format. So we're gonna split it from our src. So this will be giving our two arrays. One array will contain this much string, the other array will be containing our base URL plus this part, except this public, since we have already replaced our public with our base URL. So on the second of that index, on the second element of that index, we are gonna perform a substring function. And in that substring function, I'm gonna put it one to image path dot length. So what I'm doing here is, from our image path, this part we are extracting, we are appending to that part from the base URL till this part. So now once we have that rest.json, we will return that, and then simply say image is image path, and I can also send this way, but since the keys and the values are the same, you can directly put it there that way. So now if I save, you can see in our console we have no issues with our server, so nothing is going wrong. And now if I send again this file, that file is already there. Now we have that file path over here. So if I copy this URL and paste it in here, and if you make a get request, so you get that file back over here which we have uploaded just back. So this is the way we are gonna work with this one. And now once we are done, now we are gonna handle how we can upload multiple files together. So let's see what happens, and then we'll test it out one by one. So let's say first of all I'm gonna console.log same pattern. Let's see. Instead of this upload single, I have multi. And instead of files, I'm gonna use files. The second is also files, so currently I'm gonna use two files. Let me expand this a little bit. Actually, let's try with the three files. instead of this. This will be also file. This will be also file, and we're gonna select our files. So this is the other file. The third file is over here. That file is already uploaded, and if I open it up and make this request, you can see we are sending and getting out the message. And if I go to the console, you can see we have in our files array of the request body, we have three files. If we go ahead and check in our this public uploads directory, we have those files already uploaded to the server. So now once that part is done, now I'm gonna simply do the same stuff, but we'll do in style. Let files, so we are extracting files from our request, and this is object destructuring, and let res be equal to an empty array. So basically this is an empty array, and I'm also gonna install Node.js for our ease. So I'm gonna say npm install Node.js. This is a nice package to work with arrays and objects, so I'm gonna use that. And I'm gonna import our Node.js from there. Import from Node.js. Okay, and now we're gonna look through our files object, files array. So this was our files array, and now I'm gonna look through that. And the way we can do that is dot for each, and this will be you can go to the documentation always. Feel free to go to the documentation. So npm js Node.js, and I go to the npm Node.js. This is a package, and I'm gonna look through that. So for more about, you can go to the Node.js.com. So the way we can look through an object is there. Go to the documentation. I will pass that array. This is a for each. Let me search for. Yeah, so this is a for each. And we can look through that thing. So this will be giving us a callback. And in that callback function, we're gonna look through that files. So we can simply say files, and then it will give a callback function. File one by one, we are getting our files. And in that file, I'm gonna simply say file equal to, okay, sorry, let image path equal to dot split, the same part whole whatever we did earlier. So I'm gonna copy that part, and the same whole part will be there. Paste it, and then we're gonna save it. So in this way, we are able to extract our image path from our file one by one. And instead of this request.file, we are reusing this file, because we have already pulled files off, files array from our request object. And now we're gonna push one by one into our response. Response.push, and we'll push image path. And then once we are done with that, we'll simply return rest.json. And in this, we'll return our resp object, whatever the array we have created with our files. So this way, this is the way. So now let's go ahead and test this API again. And if I send this again, you can see we are getting three files, file links in an array. So if I go ahead and copy this link and make a get request again, oops, sorry about that. Let me copy this one, paste it inside, and send this one. And you can see our file is already there. So let me quickly close that. And you can also see our files have been uploaded to the server, and those files are also not merging, since we are uploading, as we have already uploaded the same file, but that's still not messing up. That's just because of our date now function, which will automatically rename that file and append our dates to the files. So that's it for this video, and in the next video we will start working with our front end where we can use these, consume these APIs. Thank you guys.